Okay. Now this is where a pilot, if he was flying, he would be pulling G in those tight turns. He's pulling 3 or 4 G at least. I remember when he goes upside down, that's when all the blood rushes to your head. All the yaks were built is incredibly strong aircraft, as this replica is in its own self. Built to withstand lots of positive and negative G, and it would see there's quite a lot of combustion treatment on the ground throughout the airfields and the night. The aircraft being able to take an awful lot of punishment. So here he is half holding it on the power of that engine and propeller at the same time as well. So, an update on the SIPMA. There will be a slight delay to the SIPMA program. That's going to be about a quarter past the broadcast two now. Look at the low altitude of that, and very cost control of the aircraft, he's using rudder to fly straight and level. And at the same time, he's pushing the stick slightly away, because that stops the aircraft turning. And we're coming for low approach now, and a very steady landing, one would say. Oh yes, look, even one wheel down first. Well done, Lee McCrory. Fantastic stuff. Big round of applause there. Thanks, Lee. That was super. Just going to check now whether we're going to put the other one up, as we may not have heard that we've got a bit more time. Well, of course, X-Max territory, which has got an amazing as well of 420 degrees a second, but none of these things are really superbly hit. Oh, James lost the streamer. So there we go, we put that down to some poor gaffer tape, I think. And certain stuff is doing the aerobatic manoeuvres. So it's slowing it down a little bit now. And you can see this is altogether more streamlined, more nippy little aircraft. And he just loves his nice head passes. Going up there, that was a long to back. That was the unchecked back and headache I was talking about. And he's holding it there, stall turn. That's where he's putting a big boot of rudder and a quick tumble on the way down for all good measure. Now you can imagine if you were sitting in that airplane, you absolutely would be like going in a washing machine. Better still a tumble dryer. So 2-point hesitation coming out of the old half Cuban and pushing it up now and another. Oh, it's just a hammerhead. But again. Oh, lovely stick at the top there. It's a bit of an avalanche. Marvellous stuff. So it's not surprising, it takes years and years of practice. If you're interested, I'm sure your feet will be walking around an outside turn here as he does this, just putting them back in his finger and thumb. Then you get in touch with the 7 Brick Aero Model Valley, club I should say. And also you can go to Lee's website, which is 18000, and you'll see lots of stuff in there on YouTube. And he loves to demonstrate these aerobatics in all sorts of places, heaven, mines, garages, nightclubs, all over the place. And he truly is a very committed and entertaining aviator in his own right. But he doesn't really like flying real aerobatics because he hasn't got a head for height. I'll tell you what, he'd be a really good aerobatic pilot if he did. Easily mistaken, of course, that aero models have come way, way off the edge in terms of development. Now there are big jet models, so it's a superb jet model of the Now we can tell how much practice is needed because I've got about 4,000 flying hours and still don't know how to get this, and I've done a lot of aerobatics in my time as well. So really it's just a sort of specialised art the aero modelling aerobatic world really is. Not doing a lot of talking, I've tried talking to it, but actually Hayton is so focused at the moment. It's very, very precision Fine, in a settlement, right at the top end of the aeromodeling world. Gary standing maneuvers there, and I said passes on, and he's just coming out of the half cuban with a 2-point hesitation as he was doing, he's pushing it against himself there and then finishing off with a full fair. Now we've seen a real effort, and that's it. So far, so good. Doing well on power. And picking that as he climbs there. Just holding it on the engine. And then there's almost a hover there before bringing it into that full turn we were talking about. Okay, obviously wasn't very happy with the win there. Let's try one more time, Lee. Okay, boys and girls, you've been working really, really hard here. Let's hope he gets a nice, smooth, long landing. If it doesn't tip over, we're going to go for the biggest. And now it's coming towards Mindy. Right hand down a bit, mate. Oh, yes! He's there! Oh, look at that! Fantastic! Yes, big round of applause. Right on, Lee. There he is. The Aero Modeling Maestro of the 7 Bridge Aero Modeling Club. A really outstanding fly. And thankfully, all in one piece, ready to fly another day. So that's superb. We've got a short break now. We've got about 15 minutes before the set fire rise. John, back to you. Yeah, thank you. That was really, really exciting, wasn't it? Really, really, very, very good. I did